Good morning, students. I hope everyone are fine. Okay. So today in the last class we completed up to means before holidays. Okay. November one month full month is a holiday, right? So in October last class up to we completed that is the third chapter. Up to third chapter I completed. So today we'll begin with the fourth chapter. Okay. So what is the name of the fourth chapter here? That is a linear equations in a two variables. Okay, so what is the fourth chapter? Chapter number 4, linear equations in a two variables. Okay, linear equations in a two variables. Okay, so introduction they given here. Observe page number, open page number 67, I think. Yeah, 66. Okay, page number 66. In that fourth chapter, they given here linear equations in a two variables. Already we learned the linear equation. What is the meaning of a linear equation? The equation which is having a degree 1. That is called as the linear equation. Linear polynomial. Linear polynomial is equated to some value, then we can say that is a linear equation. Okay, what is the meaning of an equation here? Equation means any polynomial is equated to some constant numbers or else some other polynomials. Okay, so in any case, here x minus y is equal to y plus n, like that also. But here having it is having the equal symbol, right? Then we can say this is a one equation. Okay, if we have to say if we that polynomial is said to be a equation, then it must contain the equation symbol, equal symbol. Okay, so this is the equal symbol. If it is containing, if the polynomial is containing the equal symbol, then we can say that is the one equation. Otherwise, it's not a equation. Okay, linear equation is nothing but having a degree as a one. Degree means what? The power of the variable. The power of the variable should be always 1. Then we can say that is called as the linear equation. If the power is 2, then we can say that is a quadratic equation. Okay, if the power is 3, then we can say that is as a cubic equation. So we are going to study about the only linear equations in a two variables. Okay, we studied already only in a one variable, right? So quadratic equation for only one variable we studied, that is a x square minus x plus 2 is equal to 0. We found x is equal to, we value of the x we already found in the last chapter only, right? So but in this chapter we are going to discuss about the linear equations in a two variables. Okay, linear equations in the two variables means what? That is nothing but go for the introduction. You will get to know that. Everyone has to open this book also. Okay, so in earlier classes you have studied linear equations in a one variable. Okay, you studied only linear equations in a one variable, but now we are going to study about the linear equations in a two variables. In only one equation we are having a two variables. Two variables is nothing but x and y. Okay, so before you already studied only for x and only for y and only for z, like that you studied already. But now in this chapter it is having a two variables. Okay, so here can you write down a linear equation in a one variable? Can you write that is a linear equation in a one variable? Yes, we can write that is a y plus x is equal y plus 5 is equal to 0 or else 2x minus 3 is equal to 0. Only one variable is there, right? We can write like that. And after that, you also know that such equations have a unique solution, which are having a only one variable. They are having a, means they have a only unique solution. Unique means what? That is a one. Only, it has a only one solution. Okay? If the variables are two, then it has a more solutions. Okay, not unique. So that they given here linear equation. That let us recall what you studied so far, then consider the following equation, that is 2x plus 5 is equal to 0. So you know how to solve this one. 2x plus 5 is equal to 0. That is nothing but 2x is equal to 10, this 5, this side will become minus, and x is equal to minus 5 by 2, right? This is the value of x here. Right? This is the value of x. Already you studied, you know this one. Right? This is nothing but a what? This is a linear equation with the only one variable. Okay, only one is the variable. X is only one variable right here. So this is the example for a linear equation having only one variable. Okay, in chapter 4, what we are studying? In chapter 4, it is the concept is linear equation in a two variable. Okay, so I'll say how to do that problems. Don't worry. So we'll see on an example. It is a write each of the following equations in the form of a ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 and indicate the values of a comma b comma c in each case. Okay, so usually linear equations in a two variable, what is the general formula for general, that is a ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. This is the linear equation of a two variable. In general, I am saying, okay, I am not considering any numbers here. This is the in general formula, okay. So, what is the quadratic equation you know, right? Ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Like that only. This is a quadratic equation, but we are discussing about the linear equation of a two variable. So, this is the general formula. Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. That is a linear equation of a two variable. In general, we write like this. That is a linear equation of a two variable. This is a general equation. General equation. Okay. So next. So I give you an example. You have to write in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. And write the values of a, b, c here. Okay. So what are the things? Wait. Yes. Example is 2x plus 3y is equal to minus 4.1. Okay, this is the one equation we are having. First, we have to write in the form of ax plus by plus c. In the form of ax plus by plus c, we have to write this given equation. Okay, so write that is a 2x plus 3y. Take this term, this is a plus 4.1 is equal to 0. Is it in the form of ax plus by plus c? Yes, right? So what are the values of a here? A is equal to 2 and b is equal to 3 and c is what? C is equal to 4.1. Okay? One second. Okay? See here, a is equal to 2 and b is equal to 3 and c is equal to 4.1. Getting right? So this is given an equation, we written in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. And what is the value of a here? A value is 2 and b value is 3 and c value is 4.1. Okay, I'll give another example. So second example. 3x minus 5y is equal to 2. Okay. So write in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. So that is nothing but 3x plus minus 5 into y plus this is the minus of 2 is equal to 0. Right. So what is the value of a here? A value is 3 and b value is minus 5 and c value is minus 2. A value is 3, B value is minus 1, C value is minus 2. Like that we have to do. It is in the form of AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0. Then if it is in the form of that value, then we can easily find the values of A, B, C. Okay. So this is the first thing. And after that, that is a write each of the following as an equation in a two variables. Okay, so this is the one type of problems. Okay, the second type of problem means they will give a solution. Okay, that is mean x is equal to 5 degree. You have to write the equation in a two variable. You have to write here. Okay, so equation in a two variable you have to write. See, so write the equation for this one. X is equal to 5 is given here. You have to write using these. You have to write the linear equation in a two variables. What is the linear equation in a two variable? That is nothing but a ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, right? So here write that one as a ax. X is only, what is the coefficient of x here? 1. So use that one. A value is here 1, x. Then b is not there. Sorry, y is not there. Y is not there means what is the coefficient of b? What is the coefficient of y here? That is a 0. So 0 into y plus c, or else write equal to, take this 5, this side minus 5 also it is correct, or else write the 5 here only. Okay, both are same, both are correct only. That is like this. Okay, this is also correct and this is also correct. You can write like this, sorry, you can write like this. Both are same and both are correct. Okay, so x is equal to 5 is given. We written the linear equation of a two variables. Like that we have to write. Linear equation in a two variable, like that we have to write. See here, x plus 0 into y is equal to 5. Okay, so whatever, if there is a y is there, y is there, then make a coefficient of x is a 0. Make a coefficient of x, that is a, as a 0. Okay, so whatever the value they given, no, you have to take another value, another coefficient is a 0 instead of taking this one. Otherwise, like this they given. 2x is equal to 5 they given, also given. Okay, then write 2x plus 0 into 1 is equal to 5. This is also linear equation in a two variable. Linear equation in a two variable. Like that you have to write. Okay, or else write the y is equal to minus h. Y is equal to minus h. Okay, then 0 into x plus 1 into y is equal to minus h. Okay, so that is the in the form of a ax plus bx plus c. Okay, take this. This side it will become a plus c only. Okay, so here this is the linear equation in a two variables. Linear equation in a two variables. Okay, so go for the exercise number 4.1. Okay, so in exercise number 4.1, what the given here? Exercise number 4.1. Exercise number 4.1. In that first question. So observe the first question in exercise number 4.1. That is, the cost of a notebook is a twice the cost of a pen. Okay, the cost of a notebook is a twice of the cost of a pen. Write a linear equation in two variables to represent this statement. Okay, The cost of a notebook is twice the cost of a pen. So write a linear equation in the two variables to represent this statement. And take the cost of a notebook is x and cost of the pen is y. The given here. First one, the given hint only. Cost of a notebook is what? Cost of a notebook is x. Next, cost of a pen. Cost of pen is equal to what? Cost of a notebook is x and cost of a pen is y. Okay, so cost of a notebook is x and cost of a pen is y here. So then what is the given? Cost of a notebook is the twice of the cost of a pen. Means cost of a pen is equal to twice. No, sorry. Cost, this is a twice, right? Cost of a notebook. Cost of a notebook is equal to what? Twice of the cost of a pen. Okay? Cost of a notebook is equal to twice of the cost of the pen. Means cost of a notebook is what? That is the x. Cost of a pen is y. Twice means what? You have to multiply with the 2. Twice means 2. Thrice means 3. Like that, okay? So it is a x is equal to 2y we are having. So this is nothing but a x minus 2y is equal to 0. Right? So this is a one of the linear equation in a two variable. Linear equation in a two variable. See here, this is in the form of, that is a 1 into x minus plus minus 2y and plus c0 is equal to 0, right? This is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. So x minus 2y equal to 0 can be written as like this in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Hence what we can say, this is the linear equation in a two variable. This is the linear equation in a two variable. The given, write that given statement in the form of a linear equation in a two variable. We return it here, linear equation in a two variable. That is the answer. Okay. So go for the second question. What the given second question? Express the following linear equations in the form of a ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 and indicate the values of a, b, c in each case. I already did some two examples, right? Similarly, like that only we have to express the given equations in the form of a, ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. And after that, we are going to write the, that is a value of a, value of b and value of c. Getting? Okay.
Now 4.1 second unit. First problem. Two x plus by is equal to 9.35. This, what is the meaning of this one? Bah. Means 3, 5 is repeating. 3, 5, 3, 5, 3, 5. Like that. First chapter. Okay. So 2x plus 3y is equal to 9.35 is there. Means we have to convert into the form of a ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Okay. So right here 2x plus 3y. Take this at this one. Minus 9.35. That is equal to 0. Okay. So what is the value of a? A value is 2, b value is 3 and c value is minus 9.35. Okay. A value is 2 and b value is 3 and c value is minus 9.35 bar. Okay. So this is the method. We have to solve like this. Okay. So next second one.
go for the second one. Easy only, don't feel difficulty, okay? Minus 10 is equal to 0. Or else write another step, you will come to this. That is a minus 9.35 or is equal to 0. This is in the form of a ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Okay? So, what is the value coefficient is there here? That's the value of a, value of a. And here, what is the coefficient of y? That is the value of b. And c is this one, minus 9.35 whole power. Okay? Let's go for this one. So, here also 1 into x here plus minus 1 by 5 into 1 plus minus of 10 is equal to 0. This is also in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Therefore, a is equal to 1 and b is equal to minus 1 by 5 and c is equal to minus 10. Okay, a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 1 by 5 and c is equal to minus 10. Okay, go for the next problem. Third, second main third problem. In third problem, that is a minus 2x plus 3y is equal to what? 6. Okay, so here minus 2x plus 3y is equal to 6. That is nothing but a minus 2 into x plus 3 into y plus minus 6 is equal to 0. This is in the form of a ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. And what is the value of a here? A value is minus 2 and b value is 3 and c value is minus 6. Right? This is in the form of this only, ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. What is the value of a? A value is minus 2, b value is 3 and c value is minus 6. Okay, go for the fourth one. X is equal to 3y. That is nothing but x minus 3y. And here plus 0 is equal to 0. And 1 into x plus minus 3y plus 0 is equal to 0. So this is in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. What is the value of a? B value is minus 3, c value is 0. Okay? Go for the next one. Fifth one. What is the fifth question? 2x is equal to minus 5y. Okay? 2x plus 5y plus 0 is equal to 0. Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. What is the value of a? 2. B is 5. And c is equal to 0. Next, sixth one. 3x plus 2 is equal to 0. 3x plus 0 into y plus 2 is equal to 0. Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Value of a is 3 and b is 0 and c is 2. Okay. So next, seventh one. Y minus 2 is equal to 0. Okay. So 0 into x plus 1 into y plus minus 2 is equal to 0. Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. What is the value of a? 0. B is 1. C is minus 2. Okay. Let's go for the 8th question. Last one. Okay. 4.1. Last problem. 5 minus 2x is equal to 0. That is nothing but minus 2 into x, 0 into y plus 5 is equal to 0. Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. What is the value of a? Minus 2. B is equal to 0 and c is equal to 5.
Okay, value of a is minus 2 and b is 0 and c is equal to 5. This is the answer. Okay, so we completed, that is the exercise number 4.1. Right, so what are the things we studied in this class? That is nothing but a linear equation. I told what is the meaning of a equation. Equation means the any polynomial which containing the equal sign, then it is called as the, in simple form we can say like this. Okay, so that is called as the equation. But if the polynomial, that equation is containing a degree is 1, means variable power is 1, then we can say that is as a linear equation. If the power is 2, then we can say that is a quadratic equation. Okay, but now we are studying about the linear equation in a 2 variable. You already studied that is a linear equation in a 1 variable. Now in this chapter you are going to study about the only linear equation in a 2 variable. First come to know the in general formula is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. That is nothing but a linear equation in a 2 variable. Okay, so what are the coefficients a, b, c? Okay, you know how to find the values of a, b, c now. And if they given a one, what is that equation? You can, you are able to write a in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Okay, so these only two things you learnt in this class. Okay, so already 4.1 is also over. In next class, we'll find how to find the solution for a linear equations in a two variables. Okay, so we'll see in the next class that one. Okay, we'll solve that is exercise number 4.2 in the next class. Okay, the homework is solve this 4.1 in your HW, after that write in a CW. Okay, so till that, be safe in your home. Okay, don't go outside and be serious about your studies, because you are in a 9th standard, it will help to your 10th standard also. So please be concentrate here. Okay, thank you everyone. We'll meet in the next class.